Yo, what's up guys? Sean here, aka ImaFlyNmidget, and today I'm joined by my boy Code Primate. What's up, dude?
Good evening, everyone. And how you doing?
Dude, I'm doing great. Hands down, I just want to say that Code has helped me so much. I got to pay the man real quick. Hold on. Send money, Code Primate, 50 Gs.
What?
And transfer. Okay, transfer pending. You need to check your bank account in just a sec, Code.
Wait, my bank account?
Yep. There you go. Bank?
Oh, dude. That's awesome.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay, so we're gonna run you through why I just paid him right now. Okay. So, as my viewers have known, I've been working on the system forever, and I wanted to pull my hair out, so I called in the big gun, Code. And he made this system work. So, Code, I'm going to let you explain how everything works because you made it work, basically.
All right. So when I first got in here, like I was like fanboying. I'm like, dude, you're like, I'm a flying midget. You're so awesome. So I came over here and I checked out his base and everything that was going on. And no offense, dude, rat's nest, like of wires and stuff.
It was nuts. There was stuff everywhere.
But he had the right idea. Like, everything was in place to do what it needed to, just in the wrong order. So
right, pretty much wrap.
Yeah, basically, he drops in a long log up here. He's got two lasers. They go off. Got a little AND switch going on here. He had these in the right spot. I actually jacked that up the first time, but we got it corrected. So if the log comes in and it hits both lasers at the exact same time, it turns off the inverters, which turns on the AND switch.
Right.
Here's your first delay signal. Comes down right about there. Turns on the second. Are these sustained? Yeah, these were sustained.
Yeah, they're both sustains. Yeah.
So we want to sustain the signal. So right. The moment both come on, it turns off the, which we also had to invert, turns off the turn right here. Oh, what is this thing called?
A switcher. I think it's called switcher.
Once that was turned off, we also kicked this hatch up so nothing else can come in behind it.
Right.
And, yeah, that's about it.
So in theory, it should work basically when a log is more than or 10 units or longer, so that way it won't go through the SOMA, because I got blown up in the comments section when I couldn't figure out why they weren't turning into planks. Anyway, so they come in here, and if they're longer than 10 units, then this will switch and it'll go into this gnarly, menacing-looking saw system.
That was another part that we worked on.
Right.
So when you started, he had the saws.
So I had them basically down. The same way, but they were flipped. So they were face down, and when you turn them on, they would go up instead of kind of going down. If that makes sense.
Yeah. Yeah.
Kind of. Yeah.
And
it was just making little pieces of bread.
We had loaves like all over here. I was building little sandcastles and stuff. It was pretty cool.
Yeah. Fun little thing. So now we've got this crazy looking machine. If you can explain the wires too if you want. So that's your idea, which I think is genius.
We've been working with wedges and everything else, and I don't like the wedges for some reason. They get stuck. You get a log stuck on them. So what we did is we came in here. You guys have seen my other videos where I'm playing with wires. We actually took the wires and used them to guide the log to the center. And then this wire right here, it actually gets stuck on. And since the log's going to be long enough anyway, it's not going to fall. So once it gets cut, those pieces are not long enough, and they'll fall to the left and to the right.
Boom. And then they fall down, and then I obviously haven't made this conveyor system down here yet, but then this conveyor system will carry on and meet back up with this one up here, this one that they switch on, and then they'll eventually make it into the sawmill. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, that's kind of the system. Shall we test it out and just cross our fingers it works?
Oh, I hope it works.
I don't see my car. Looks like you're driving.
Uh-oh. Well, hold on. I've got a green box around me again. There we go. Green screens, right?
Green screens, what are you going to do? Yeah, my green screen looks nice, right, guys? All right, let's roll.
What do you want to pick up?
Let's go get one of those really big, fat ones right there. See next to the pink tree? To our right?
Oh, there we go.
Yeah, let's go snag one of these guys. So I initially wanted this system for just any types of wood, like lava, pretty much anything that just wouldn't go through the sawmill. And we've only really tested it with this wood. But I'm assuming it works with all woods. Hopefully.
Oh, we didn't measure out actual 10 units, did we?
No, that's another thing. And once we get back there, my viewers know that I am extremely OCD. So I will probably be reworking the machine and making it look nice. Because we were just going for full utility. We just wanted it to work.
We wanted the functionality and the idea. And like I said, guys, you have an idea. It turns into a project. Those projects turn into reality.
Right. I'm telling you, I was scratching my head over this project for it. I've never seen that happen.
What?
I've never seen that happen before.
That
is
yeah.
So cool.
Skills.
Skills. Calculated. All right, let's roll this bad boy in the back here. Whoa.
Sorry. I moved on you. My parking brake was off.
There we go. Uh-oh. It's probably going to glitch. We don't have far to go.
Oh,
that was close. That was close. Okay, yeah, so I'm going to be making this look a little bit better when I get a little more time, but oh, genius. Oh. And round two, or not.
All good.
All right, so this piece is very, very long. So hopefully the timing works, because this one is incredibly long. Might want to turn the saws on.
Yeah, it might not get around the corner there.
I was going to say, this one might be just too long in general.
Oh, that's loud. Oh, hold on. No, wrong one. Fail.
All right, I don't think it's going to make it around the corner. This is super long.
Sorry, I was thinking long planks.
Let's see.
Oh. Rip.
I'll just give her a little chop. And about right there.
Oh, it's moving. Okay.
I think it's just glitching a little bit. Just chop this little end off here. And skadoosh. Okay. Move that one out of the way. That little bump there.
There we go.
Alright, so it hits one laser, hits the second, open. And oh, it looks so flush.
Delay. Came up
and chop, 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 chop.
Nice.
Oh, it looks so fluid. It's so nice. And then these will eventually drop down.
Oh, what happened there?
Yeah, I'm not sure if these saws are actually cutting on this left side. Oh, they sometimes do. I guess when the log gets all a little bit messed up.
It's kind of cool.
I know, it is pretty cool. And they just keep chopping down, and then I got to get this conveyor system, like, complete down here.
Got a little stuck.
Oh, there we go.
It's turned sideways.
Yeah, I think it just got a little bit tweaked.
There it goes.
There we
go. That's perfect.
Yeah, like so they come down in these nice chunks that'll just fit perfectly into these, into the sawmill here. If it wants to go, bam.
The cubing on this thing. Like,
I know.
Do you see this?
Do you see that? Yeah, I was going to say, I wonder if that was just for me.
Hey,
this is loud. I'm turning this off.
Default IO. There's your quadratic formula on the right-hand side, but I don't know what happened to the left. Is that actually a solid object? No, it's not.
No.
Okay.
I know. It was like messy. I thought it was only on my screen. I was like, maybe it's just for me. But, okay. And also, this just quad, like, saw just looks so sick and menacing. Oh, love it. I love it. So, yeah, and then eventually those two paths will meet back up on one path again. So then you've got all your logs on one system that will all fit through your sawmill. Pretty unique system.
Very cool.
Kind of like it. But let's go check out your stuff real quick, Code.
Let's do it.
Because I know you've got some really sick stuff. And for everyone watching on my channel, guys, Code has some gnarly creations that you guys need to definitely check out.
Hold on 1 second. Hold on. Did I leave a piece of wire over here? I didn't. Okay, I'm good.
Do you need a piece of wire?
No, I was going to have you sign your name.
Ah. Also, wait, how did you make that axe sign glow?
Not seen that?
What? Oh, that's wiring.
Yeah.
Hold on, wait a minute. This is sick. Okay, that's really sweet.
Mm-hmm. I had another idea, and I've not come back to it yet, but I was going to actually draw two axes out of wire
and have them
alternate so it looks like a chopping axe.
You got a little bit of axes in there, just a little bit.
Yeah, you know, a couple.
Yeah.
By the way, this is no longer a shop. This is a museum.
Ah.
And all of these axes have actually... Here, let me open this thing up.
All right, let's just take a little gander in here. You actually have boxed axes. That's impressive.
And every single thing that you see in here, minus like two alphas, one beta, and maybe a fire, have been gifts from fans. Like,
wow.
This is all gifts.
This would be awkward if I pressed open box, huh?
Don't do that.
I'm just kidding. this is pretty sweet.
That's like the only one that I've got left, dude. Like,
I know. I was like, oof.
You shouldn't come over here. Day. Just don't come over here. Don't look at this stuff over here.
Don't look at what?
Underneath this big red one. Like, what? Don't look over here.
You don't have a lot of stuff. I thought I had a lot of presents. Holy crap. Holy cow, dude. This is nuts.
Yeah.
Huh.
So that was from one pink truck load full, which, by the way, it was not that pink truck. I've lost one pink truck, one pink car, and like all kinds of other stuff.
I also want to just kind of slip this in here. I may or may not have lost my pink truck that was in the last episode. May or may not. You know, just, you know, putting it out there.
Oh, dude. What? Come here. Look at this over here. Now,
what do you got?
This was not here, but I don't know. Look at read it. Read it.
Interesting. Default IO.
Now,
I may or may not be the creator of the game.
I didn't do that. All right. And I don't know of anybody that would have done it because I haven't whitelisted anybody to do their own names in, gosh, it's like 2 months. Almost That's 2 months. So it wasn't there. I don't think it was there. I'm going to have to go back to my videos and look to see if like that appeared. But I'm kind of freaking out right now.
Huh.
So, okay. Let's sign your name.
Okay. Yeah. Let's sign my name real quick. We'll get Midget penned in.
Do you want to do the honors or?
You're probably way better than I am.
All right.
So I'll let you do it.
So, what would you like me to sign?
Let's just do Midget on there.
All right.
Also, you've got a little bit of Spookwood and a little bit of Goldwood.
Yeah. Again, everything that you see is a gift.
Wow. I thought I got a lot of gifts, and now I came over here, and I'm just feel like the non-favored child on Christmas right now. That's how I'm feeling.
No, dude, you are the coolest. Oh, real quick, yeah. Just so everybody knows, he's got 92K. All right, there's no way. I don't even touch him, okay? But I saw that he was having trouble on the sawmill. I kind of reached out to him, and blessed be, here we are now, doing a collaborative. It's awesome.
I must say, I can't even touch you on the Lumber Tycoon knowledge, so.
Thank you.
There you go.
Thank you. My hat off to you, sir.
Yeah, my hat off to you.
What do we say? Just Midget?
Yeah, you can put Midget on there. Wherever you want to put it. I'm gonna while you pen that in a little bit, I'm gonna show a little bit of my viewers kind of what you got rocking here, because I know you have some crazy systems on here that I was kind of playing around with. This quad saw that you had where you drop your trees down.
Yeah.
When I first saw that system, I thought it was genius, and that's initially the saw system I tried to drop into my conveyor system, and was like running into some issues with the log not being pushed far enough, and I was like, this is such a cool system, but it's just not gonna work with mine. So then I tried new ideas, but this is like the cool, I think it's such a cool thing. It's just, you drop it in and it's just going to get chopped. It's just going to get wrecked, basically. Oh, it's it's so sweet. I love that system.
It's pure annihilation, and it's a beautiful thing to listen to. It just hum.
It does look pretty sweet. And then, so you just showed me, so how new is this trapdoor system that you're showing me? Is this pretty new, or have you had this for a little while?
Which one?
The trapdoor one? Or the pressure plate, I mean?
Oh, that's just 2 weeks old, I think.
Okay. It's a pretty nifty system. I like it.
Oh, no.
Look, I might have broke it.
The wire's too short.
Oh.
No, get it?
Ha ha. Ha ha.
Gotcha. Got him!
Got him! Okay. Also, how do you have these huge pillars of these wood?
Those are gifts, and I've been questioned about it. Like, dude, did you duplicate those? No. I promise.
Dude, these are interesting. I don't have, my wood's not that big.
MIDG. I'll give you like a gangster E looking thing here.
Ooh, let's see. What do we got? What do we got rocking here?
I'm on the top floor. Whoops.
Also, is this Goldwood? This second ladder, or this third ladder? I mean. Also, how does one ladder? What the heck? Come on, Sean. There we go. All right, let's see. What do you got? Where is it? Oh, it's on the ground. Oh.
Yeah.
That looks pretty good. I like it.
MIDGET. I was horrible at spelling bees.
But your rhyming's on point.
I'm a poet.
He doesn't even know it. Ha.
Oh.
Oh, bars.
All right, let's go.
Also, Code, you might need to get a little bit of a tan. Your character's looking pretty white.
That's my style.
Just saying, dude. If you want, we can hit up the tanning bed sometimes.
Oh, yeah. Hook it up, man. I don't like the way that T's going. It's okay. B, B, B.
B.
B. Yeah, B is an undo.
Ah. Interesting.
Yeah, I'll tell you what.
Also, do you know what these little red balls do? Or are they just for fun?
I think they're just for fun. You can get them during Christmas time.
Okay, because I got like a bunch of them, and I don't know what to do with them. Oh, well.
All right, finished. There you go.
How's that? Ooh, that looks good.
That way it kind of comes over.
Actually, looks real good.
Sweet.
I even do that on my signature. I like bring back the thing and go over. Mm-hmm. Zoom, zoom. That's pretty sweet, dude.
Face the ladder. Like, look right at the bottom part of the gold ladder. I'm going to take a selfie.
Okay, get a selfie going.
Oh, maybe not. Maybe. Oh, no, you're like way over here. Okay, maybe. Here, right there.
Okay,
hold
good.
Still.
Focus, and smile.
Focus. Oh, I blinked.
I got it.
And boom, done.
Nailed it.
Nice.
Do I look good? Hold on, I got to see it before you post it.
Okay, cool.
Okay, cool. Cool. Oh, how does one? Okay, cool. Yeah, awesome.
Just kind of fall down in there.
Oh, sweet.
Very cool.
Yeah.
Anything else you need to build for? Actually, no. It's getting really late. And
it's getting pretty late.
What have we done? It's been about 2 hours.
Spent a little bit. It's a little bit of time on trying to get that machine to work. I must say we did spend a little bit of time on it. But it looks sweet, and I thank you so much for it.
Anytime. Awesome. My name is Heath Haskins, Code Primates. Go for it.
I'm Sean, a.k.a. the realest midget around. Subscribe to Code.
Subscribe to Midget. Absolutely. Like, comment, subscribe down below. There's no pressure from me, maybe from him.
Definite pressure from me.
Love you guys. Have a good night.
Later.
Bye.